Hey everybody, and welcome back to my channel. I am your host, the Rambling Film Lover, and on today's episode I wanted to talk about deaf actors and roles for deaf actors. So I was re-watching a great film the other day. It's from 1986, called Children of a Lesser God. It's based on a play, and it's about a teacher, played by William Hurt, who starts his new job in a New England school for the deaf as a teacher. And his character is not deaf. His character is teaching a small class of teenagers not how to sign, not how to read or anything, specifically because they're teenagers, they already know how to read and write. He's specifically teaching them to speak out loud, and I think also to like read his lips. I'm not positive about that part. No, I think he was just doing that with the other character, but he is teaching them to pronounce, to enunciate, to talk. And it's a classroom full of teenagers, so there's, you know, the students that are excited, the more rebellious students, and then the more broody students who are, I guess they're a bit shy or whatnot. But he has, you know, I mean, adolescence is awkward enough. Now you're also going through it, kind of trying to build up the courage to pronounce words. But he's a very good teacher, and he's there just for a little bit before he notices a young woman. And he notices her because she's signing very passionately, because she's fighting with another staff member, and he's amused by what she's saying, because what she's saying isn't very PG.
Take your pots and your lousy food and shove. Doesn't mince words, does she?
And he's just immediately taken by her. You know, she's very beautiful as well. She's this mysterious, young, alluring, passionate, almost angry woman. And he asks, I believe, the principal or the dean of the school about her. And he, apparently she's from that school. She went to that school. And not only that, she was an excellent student. I think the best, they say, the brightest. And her name is Sarah. And she's the janitor now. So I guess after she finished her school, she didn't really go anywhere else. She just stayed there and she got a job there and pretty much kept to herself. And so William Hurt's character engages with her a few times, but she's very gruff, so she really doesn't stick around too long for his conversations. It's what he was trying to do was talk to her. He wanted to see if he can help her learn to speak, but she doesn't care. She won't have any of that. She's not interested. And she brushes him off and even will leave him just standing there the few times he's attempted to engage further and to find out why she doesn't want to talk. You know, why she's content just signing. It's only after he asks the dean, I guess, for the favor to formally ask her to speak with him one last time that, you know, she sits with him in his classroom. But she basically says she has no interest in that. And there is more to her character. You find out much more. Her character has gone through a lot. And Marlee Matlin, the actress who portrays Sarah, puts a brilliant performance. I mean, brilliant. She is very passionate. It's all in her eyes. She's a very small actress, especially in the scenes with William Hurt. William's very tall, but she carries herself very well. She just exudes this fire that Sarah has. It's a mix of defiance, it's passion, it's fear, it's happiness, it's insecurity. She's able to show those emotions brilliantly. And she won an Oscar for it, actually. I think she won it at 21 years old. So Marlee Matlin is still holding the record for the youngest Best Supporting Actress winner. And I grew up in the 90s, so that brings me to the next topic. For that time, most of my childhood, and from the 90s to pretty much the beginning of the 2000s, Marlee Matlin was the actress. She was the only deaf actress really out there in films and in television. You know, she was infamously in that Seinfeld episode, and I saw her in Law and Order SVU. She's been in a lot of stuff, and she's a great actress. But she was the only one. You know, we didn't really have that many roles for deaf actors. And I know there is theater, there are plays where all the actors are deaf. And so that has been around for a while. That's actually where Marlee Matlin was discovered. Henry Winkler, the actor who played the Fonz, he had seen her in a play in like 1984 or 5 or whatnot. And then I think he introduced her, or he mentioned her to either a casting agent or a director. But that's how she got the role of Sarah in Children of a Lesser God. So it's not a tale that's too different from other actors. There are other actors that get discovered on stage. So Marlee Matlin was always an actress. She was trained for it. And when I saw, let's fast forward to 2010s, because I saw this film a little bit later. I saw the film There Will Be Blood, starring Daniel Day-Lewis. And in that film, he adopts a little boy, and he adopts a baby boy, and a couple of years later, the little boy, I think he's like 7 or 8, he suffers an accident that leaves him with no hearing. And so for a good part of the film, he's just a child. But near the end of the film, there is another actor that plays Daniel Day-Lewis's son as an adult. And he's played by the deaf actor Russell Harvard. And number one, the scene he's in, because he's only in a few scenes near the end, but the scene where he's talking to his father, or rather, his father's berating him for a good minute or whatnot. The scene where he's talking with his father, where he actually utters a few words for him because his father demands it, that scene was just beautiful.
I know you and I have disagreed over many things. I'd rather keep you as my father than my partner.
Then say it. You've got something to say to me, then say it. I'd like to hear you speak instead of your little dog. Woof, 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 woof.
I'm going to Mexico with my wife. I'm going away from you.
And Russell did, again, a wonderful job, just with his eyes and his body language and even the tone of his voice. And I just thought, wow, this young man is a great actor. And after I saw that, I was like, why don't we have anything more? And I don't mean more roles that specifically this character is deaf. Like, I mean just a role, any role that a deaf actor can play. And when the series Fargo came out, I was hooked on it. It's such a great show. But when season 3 rolled around, I recognized one of the characters. And it was Russell Harvard. One of the characters in that season is called Mr. Wrench. Sorry, it was actually season 1. I'm mixing them up. Russell Harvard's character is predominantly in season 1, but you do see him again in season 3 in some really great action-packed episodes. And it just got me thinking. I wish there could be a show where the main actor and the main character is deaf. And I think it can be done, or at least I know for sure it can be entertaining if, by what we've been seeing right now coming out of Netflix and Hulu and whatnot, there's a lot of great shows that are so different, that they're so creative, that they're really breaking boundaries and they're just attempting stuff that's breaking the mold that's been used, God, since I was a kid. And I hope it brings more actors out. Russell Harvard also came out of, I think, theater too, like Marlee Matlin. And he's got the talent. And, you know, he could play like a lead in a comedy film. If you guys haven't seen Russell Harvard, he has a YouTube channel. And he's actually really funny. And he's actually a musician, so you guys should definitely check him out. Check out that channel. I actually am subscribed to him. But from those videos, I can see that he can definitely play like... God, he could be the lead in a romantic comedy. You know, what do you think of that? I totally think he could. And yes, he's also very handsome. Let's just get that off the table. He's a very good looking, handsome man. Yes. But aside from that, I do think he's very talented. I like how expressive he is with his eyes. He can also play a very intimidating character too. Or let's say he did a show where he's the main character, like I don't know, let's think of something like a gritty drama or an investigative show. Everybody's a sucker for investigative shows. Isn't that like everything that the ID channel is? He can play like a private investigator who either works on his own or works with somebody else, and we can have him engaging with detectives. And well, he has to actually talk to a lot of other people. He has to engage with a lot of other people. We can have him talking with, I don't know, bounty hunters too. We can really make a good show around this one character who happens to be deaf. But he has this job, like anyone else, an interesting job. You know, maybe it's a job where he's sometimes a night owl or whatnot. Like, it's all hours of the day and sometimes dangerous. And we've seen that he can do action, so he can be in some really precarious situations. But I think it would be really entertaining, and I would love to see something like that. So like Netflix, if you're listening or whatnot, hit me up. Let's come up with something, because I really do think, or I guess I'm really putting it out there that I want to see stuff like this with actors like Marlee Matlin, like in the lead, and not just always with someone else, because I guess sometimes it's easier to use like maybe another character to help them say what the person is saying. No, let's have them in the forefront. And if they're signing, if and when they're signing, you know, you can put like the subtitles on the bottom or something like that. Yeah, I think I would really like to see something like that. What do you guys think? You know, would you watch something like that? Would you watch a romantic comedy where the lead, the main actor, the main character, the main actress is deaf? Would you see a show, you know, like a Netflix show where the main character, the main character uses sign language and occasionally, you know, speaks? I guess hopefully the correct answer is yes, I would watch that show if, you know, the writing is good, you know, and all the acting is good. But yeah, let me know what you guys think. Also, let me know if there are any other actors I may have missed. Again, growing up, Marlee Matlin was like the main, honestly, the sole deaf actress until I saw Russell Harvard come up. But yeah, if there are any other actors you guys know out there, please let me know. If there are any specific theaters, deaf theaters, please let me know too, because I would love to check one of those out. If there are any other films where some of the cast are deaf, please let me know. I always love recommendations. I always watch any recommendations because I'm always looking for something new to see, and I'm always interested in growing my lexicon of films and shows. And yes, please check out Children of a Lesser God. It's a fantastic film. Or let me know what you thought of it. And then, yes. Also, I'm saying yes a lot. Yes. Please watch Fargo. And let me know what you think of that. I am a fan of the film Fargo, but I really love the shows that much more. Probably because it's a show and it's the world of Fargo, like, stretched out or expanded. And so I'm a glutton for good material. So I'm starting to prefer shows a little more than films. What am I saying? I'm a cinephile. Yeah, just kidding. Yeah, leave any comments you have below, anything interesting that I should check out. And again, please check out Russell Harvard's awesome YouTube channel. Send the guy some love. He's really talented. And I'm planning on uploading an ASMR video soon, I'm hoping. But if not, I have a good idea for what my next rambling episode will be. So again, thanks guys so much for checking out my channel, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.
Hey, all right. There's no library in this town. Why is there no library in this town?
Cutbacks?
He thinks every town should have a library.
I agree. Tell him I agree.